They look more or less human, but I think they're mute.
That bright eyes is remarkable.
Natural born thieves, aren't they?
The sooner he is exterminated, the better. It's a question of simian survival.
Dr. Zayas. Cornelius.
It's a stunt.
Get me a collar and leash. I'm taking him out of here.
He's vicious, Doctor. Besides, it's against the rules.
Do as I say.
I'm not going to get into that battle.
Which one was wearing the strange clothes?
This one.
Cornelius! Will he live?
I don't know. This beast has lost a lot of blood.
Dr. Zayas!
There's no probe here. Find one.
Yes, sir.
This place is dirty, Doctor.
Doctor, these animals are dirty. They stink and they carry communicable diseases. Why aren't they cleaned up before they're brought here?
You don't sound happy in your work.
Little more than a vet in this laboratory. You promised to speak to Dr. Zayas about me.
I did. You know how he looks down his nose at chimpanzees.
But the quota system's been abolished. You made it, why can't I?
What do you mean, made it? I'm animal psychologist, that's all. We have no authority.
You do all right when it comes to getting space and equipment.
That's because Dr. Zayas realizes our work has value. The foundations of scientific brain surgery are being laid right here. Studies of cerebral functions of these animals.
They're still dirty, Doctor. And the bite is septic. There, look at that. Hold his jaw.
Good morning, Dr. Zira.
Good morning, Julius. How's our patient today?
No change. The minute you open the door, he goes into his act.
Well, and what do we want this morning? Do we want something? Come on, speak. Come on, speak. Do we want some sugar, old-timer?
You could get hurt doing that, Doctor.
Oh, don't be silly. He's perfectly tame.
They're all tame until they take a chunk out of you.
Well, Bright Eyes, is our throat feeling better? Still hurts, doesn't it?
See? He keeps pretending he can talk.
That Bright Eyes is remarkable. He keeps trying to form words.
You know what they say. Human see, human do. Now what?
He seems to want something.
I'd be careful, Doctor. What'd I tell you?
I'll try that again and I'll break your arm!
Good morning, Your Excellency.
Dr. Zayat.
Good morning, sir.
Open up, please.
I'm so glad you could come. Sir, he's over here. Bright eyes. Show him. Go ahead, do your trick. Speak. Go on, speak again. There. Can you believe it?
Yes, amusing. A man acting like an ape.
Dr. Zayas, I could swear he's answering you.
He has a definite gift for mimicry.
It's most unusual. He's using that old blanket as clothing. I wonder how he'd score on a Hopkins manual dexterity test.
An animal?
Look, he's moving his fingers.
Only because he saw you moving yours.
No, but perhaps he understood.
Man has no understanding. He can be taught a few simple tricks, nothing more.
I'm afraid I must disagree. According to my experiments...
Dr. Zirar, I must caution you. Experimental brain surgery on these creatures is one thing, and I'm all in favor of it. But your behavioral studies are something else again. To suggest that we can learn anything about the simian nature from a study of man is sheer nonsense. Right, man is a nuisance. He eats up his food supplies in the forest, then migrates to our green belts and ravages our crops. The sooner he is exterminated, the better. It's a question of simian survival.